Hi everyone, welcome back. Now Optuma is full of time-saving features and tools that have been designed to make your life as a trader and analyst so much easier. And one of the most popular ones is the Custom Toolbar. And that allows you to create your own buttons to the top of the screen for all your favorite tools and actions and for templates and layouts and so on. So over the next few minutes, I'll be showing you how to add these to your copy of Optuma. When you first log in, your custom toolbar will obviously be empty. So that's this area at the top of the screen to the right of the menu icons. But what we can do is put on some tools and then create buttons for your preferred ones that you use a lot. So I'm just going to go ahead and using the right click menu, go to the wrench. I'm going to type moving average and select that from the list and then change the properties. Again, remembering to right click and go to the pencil icon for the properties to change them accordingly. So I'm going to make this a 20 based on the close and I'm going to change it from green to blue. Still got the right click menu open. I'm going to go over to the running man, the actions icon, and that second option listed there is add to toolbar. And when I click that, you'll see that there's now a button that's been added to the toolbar called MA, which is the shortcut for moving average. Now what we can do, I'm going to delete the blue line from the chart. So every time I want that 20 period moving average on my chart, I just click that button and then click on the chart. And there it is applied. Now we can change the label to be more descriptive. So we can right click on that button, then all these options pop up. So the tool name is moving average. The label is MA, but I'm gonna change that to 20. So we know what it is. We can even give it a keyboard shortcut. We can have an image on the button and even change the color as well. So I'm just going to click away there now. I'm going to put another moving average on the chart. I'm going to right click there, change that from 20 to 50, and change the color to red. And this time, instead of using the actions menu, what I can also do is click and drag up to the toolbar. And then let go, and there's the button there for the 50 period. So again, I can right click, change the label to 50 MA. And we can have as many buttons up there as you like. But one of the time-saving or space-saving features we have is we click the little plus sign. So we've actually got two rows. So you can manipulate, you can click and drag and put them wherever you like. But when you click the plus sign, you get a lot more options. So you can choose just to have an icon and text for the button, just an icon or text only. So if I choose text, it makes the buttons that much smaller. But what I want to do this time is add a folder. So I'm going to select that, and I'm going to call this folder Moving Averages. So what's great about this is you can have one tool set with several different settings, whether it be moving average values, it could be Fibonacci retracements with different levels, and you can have multiple versions of the same tool, each with their own button. So now we've got that folder there for moving averages. I'm literally going to click and drag those buttons into the folder. So I'm going to click and then drop them there. So now when I mouse over that moving average folder, the drop down appears and the buttons are underneath. One more example for adding these tools is I'm going to add yet another moving average and change it to another 200 period, so longer term, and change that to green. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to left click on the green 200 moving average while holding the control key on my keyboard. and you'll see that it's turned orange. So I've still got my finger down on the control button, and now I'm going to click on the red 50, turns orange, and then the blue 20. So now all of them have turned orange. I've let go of the control key. I'm going to right click on any of those orange lines. I'm going to go to the actions, the running man, and I'm going to add tools to toolbar. And now we've got a button there called tools. Again, I'm going to right click to get what's included under there. So you can see I've got the three moving averages. So now instead of having three separate buttons for each of those moving averages, I've got one. I'm going to change the label to, I'm just going to call it 3MAs. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to open up a new chart. I'm just going to double click, open that. And now when I click the 3MAs button, they automatically, all three in one go, get applied to the chart. So the custom toolbar can be used for tools, and also actions, layouts, folders we've already covered, and also workbooks. You can create buttons for that way as well. So what I'm going to do now is just show you some examples of a toolbar that I previously created. So here we have an example of some other buttons that I previously prepared. So we got different colors, as I said, for different types of tools or actions. So if I wanted to close my workbook, I've created a button there that does exactly that. So I click close, and then you get the prompt, do I want to save the changes? I'm just going to cancel that. And that's by adding an action. So click the plus, add action, and then from the action dropdown, you can make anything you like, such as a logarithmic scale. So click away. So now if I wanted to change my chart to log, I just click that and the price scale changes. And again, click it again to turn it off. Now to delete these buttons, if you don't want them anymore, as you mouse over, you see there's a little cross in the top right corner. Just click that and then it'll ask you if you want, are you sure you want to delete that? Click yes, and then it will be removed. A couple of other examples, I've created buttons for timeframes. So as well as keyboard shortcuts and drop down here, I can just click the button to change the time frame. So that's weekly, that's monthly, and then back to daily. And again, that's through the actions. So add action, change the time frame. A couple of other examples. So I've got horizontal line, save twice. Once, if you right click on the button, it'll tell you the properties. So that's a green horizontal dashed line, whereas the stop loss is red. And I can move that into my lines folder. So I'm just gonna click and drag the buttons there, stop loss into lines. So now I've got, when I mouse over the lines folder, I've got just a regular green horizontal. There's my trend line. So I can draw a trend that way. So once again, knowledge base article has lots more information on the custom toolbar. So again, go to the, highly encourage you to go to the website, optuma.com. help.optuma.com/KB, and then you can search for any of these things that you see in these videos to get more information. And of course, as always, let us know if you have any questions. Thanks very much.